Hello everyone, welcome back to my 1086 series. This segment is going to be on the HVAC stuff, so the heating and air conditioning. I'm not sure we're going to really do anything with the AC at all, but we are going to try and get at least the blower motor working and possibly the heat. I started digging into it a little bit. I did take the panel off up on the roof, so we'll go up there now and check that out. This is the heater core and the AC condenser. As well as any of the rest of the HVAC stuff that's under the roof here. When I first took the lid off, I guess I wasn't really sure what to think. Obviously, it's really dirty. Everything needs to be vacuumed out and cleaned out. But everything looks like it's here. There's even some fairly new wiring on the blower motor. But for whatever reason, it's not hooked up to the fan switch. Possibly the fan switch is bad, or there might be something else going on, but we'll have to dig into that a little bit. But none of the AC stuff is hooked up. There's some wires missing. I have a feeling that if a guy wanted to get the AC working on this thing, you could drop $1,000 into it pretty easy, and that's just really not in the budget. So AC is probably a no-go. But I would like to try and get the heat working. They did tell us when we bought the tractor that the nipple was rusted off of the heater core. That was not the case. Now that I am up here inside the roof, what I found is that the hose that, or the metal pipe that comes up the pillar that goes to the heater control valve and then into the heater core, that metal pipe is what's rusted off. So originally we were looking at maybe a $400-$600 heater core. Now we're hopefully looking at a much cheaper tube that just runs up that pillar. So I gotta look into that and see if it's gonna be something that is maybe in the budget, because I would really like to try and get that heat working. But we are gonna have to get all this crud out of here. The foam that goes on the inside of the cab roof deteriorated and got down and plugged up the core, so it'll take some time with a shop vac and blow gun to clean all this out, and then you want to clean it out too, so when you turn the fan on for the first time it doesn't fill your cab full of crap. But yeah, that's what it looks like up here. So I took the corner molding off here. This is where our heater pipes run. Obviously this is where it's supposed to come from the engine and go up to the heater core and then back to the engine. So this is the return line, I believe, because it's not insulated. So, you know, there'd be no reason to heat the coolant that's kind of, or keep the coolant coming back warm. But that one looks to be in good shape. But the one that's supposed to keep the coolant warm on the way up has got, padding around it. And that one is absolutely shot. I mean, that's the pipe falling out of there. So that one, we're going to take that off. I'm going to go look and see what it costs to replace that. Like I said, I would really like to get that working for him, but we'll see if it's something that's reasonable or not. I don't know if you can just run a hose there instead. I would imagine there's probably some complications with that, or they would have done a hose instead of a pipe, but that's kind of where that's at. Like I said, the AC side of things, for sure the low pressure switch is not hooked up. It's an R12 system still, so that's not great. I just don't think it's worth the money and the work that's going to go into getting the AC system working. Not for the amount of time that he's going to spend in the tractor. So we'll probably leave that be. But like I said, I would like to get the heater working, so I'll check the price on that. But first thing I got to do is get that blower motor working. Figure out, and I can use my power probe to send power to the different leads, but we got to figure out what's the ground for that blower motor, and then figure out if that blower motor doesn't factor on, then we can kind of proceed from there. If the blower motor doesn't work, then you know you're looking at a little bit more expense, and we'll have to kind of analyze that and see if that's something that is worth fixing. The only reason I'm really concerned about it is if he decides to put the snowblower on this tractor in the wintertime, keeping the windows from fogging up and stuff like that. Otherwise, he doesn't really spend enough time in them to need that working that bad. But with this being a sealed cab, unlike the older tractors where you added the cab on top of the tractor and you got a lot of that heat from the engine up into the cab, you can pull this full cab off of here and it's all enclosed all the way around. And so it doesn't let that engine heat and stuff into the cab like the old ones do. So I would like to try and get that fixed. So I'll keep you guys posted with what I find there. All right, guys, we're back topside here. I'm going to use my power probe to check and see if the blower motor works. If you guys do any sort of electrical diagnostic stuff, these power probes are got to be one of the handiest tools out there. They give you the ability to send power to something. You can check your voltage at your battery doing that as well. They also give you the ability to send ground. And so, you know, if you're trying to complete a circuit where maybe you think you might have a bad ground, you can touch it and you can connect that to battery ground. This has got leads on it that go right to the battery. You can also check continuity with it right here. And then you can also send or connect that to ground there as well. So a lot of different things you can do with this tool. The biggest thing you have to be careful with the power probe is it's going to send 12 volts to something. So if you're working with like microcomputers and stuff like that, not necessarily the greatest tool. But anything you know that gets 12 volts, lights, blower motors, things like that, these things are super, super handy. So we're going to go ahead and these are our three wires for our blower motor. I'm assuming it's got three different speeds. So we're going to go ahead and just test this blower motor here quick and see if the blower motor works. So that's a good sign right there. That tells me that that is currently a grounded circuit, which means that the blower motor is grounded. And when I send power to this, that motor should come on. And it does. So we've got one speed working there. Let's try the next one here. Got one speed working there. And we've got another speed working there. So the orange one is our high speed. And it sounds like the yellow one is probably the middle speed or the medium speed, and then the red one is the low speed. So that's good news. We'll obviously have to do some wiring stuff here because the connectors look like they kind of melted, or this one's bad for sure. But that's not a big deal. So let's figure out if the fan switch here is bad, if that's what needs to be replaced. So we'll have to do some continuity testing on that. But for now, I'd say that's good news. Our blower motor does work, even if we just wanted to get some air circulation through there. If it's warm in the summertime or something like that, and we just want to blow some air in the cab, we can turn that on. And even if it came down to it, if the switch was bad and that switch is expensive, you could just hook a toggle switch up to the medium speed or whatever and just run it that way. So, I'll get that switch out of there and we'll do a little bit of testing on that as well.